Holy crap, here we go. What's up, pipes? The sound of that.
What the fuck was that?
You were so scared.
Thank you.
combat zone.
I handled that.
There.
I don't think I can pick this.
Get away from me.
Shoot him.
They're gonna love you.
I like money.
You think they're done out there?
We don't want any trouble! Anymore, at least.
Oh, just peek your head up, you damn coward.
The heck with that? I'm too pretty to go out with this. You finished tearing the place up now? Hey! You all done killing each other? Why don't you come over here? Show us you don't mean no harm. So you wanna talk this out like civilized folk? Or are you just gonna bash up my theater some more? Is it over? Well, that could've gone worse.
I dunno. Seemed quite the performance from where I was standing.
Are you fucking high or something? Why am I asking? Of course you are.
Still won the fight, didn't I?
You're strung out and getting sloppy, is what you are.
Boss, I suppose you ain't gotta worry about that now. Seems this one just put us out of business. I'm not sure if I should kiss you or have my little bird here feed you your own entrails.
I told you to quit calling me that.
I'm sorry? It just seemed like you guys might be in trouble.
Trouble? Nah. But keeping those idiots entertained was what kept the lights on. Not exactly sure what we're gonna do now.
To hell with them! More'll come. Just need a quick breather and I'll be ready to go.
Oh, breather? What? So you can slam more of that junk into your arm now? Now, you know what? I think this was a blessing in disguise. You caught the end of that bout. What'd you think of Kate's work?
She's clearly talented.
See? At least someone knows skill when they see it.
It ain't your fighting skills I'm concerned with. So here's my predicament. I suddenly got no audience. No audience means I got no caps coming in.
And if you ain't bringing in caps, little bird, you ain't an asset. You're a liability to me and to yourself. So, here's what I'm thinking. What's...
Sure.
Look, you'd be doing me a favor.
Me?
Uh-huh. Sure. I could use someone watching my back.
Good. It's settled then. And here, take this. It's the purse from the last fight. Exterminator's fee.
Now just wait a second. What exactly are you gonna do without me here?
You don't need to worry about me. I'll get this place set up right. Maybe find a less blood-soaked clientele. Now get the hell out of here. You ain't welcome anymore, little bird.
You're a real son of a bitch. You know that, Tommy?
You don't have to tell me.
I guess you just come find me then when you want to head out.
Animals on either side of this cage.
Hey.
So, you're ready to head out?
That depends. How are you feeling?
I don't know. Feeling kinda useless sitting here with me thumb up me arse. So, are you ready to get this show on the road?
Ready.
About time I got out of this place. Let's go.
So, no one's managed to put you in the ground yet, Kate?
Not yet. Though it isn't for lack of trying. Need something?
That's all for now.
Sure.
Thank you.
You say the word.
Know if you find some spare ammo.
Seven and A. Some sort of code.
Now they're back!
Now a six and an O.
Up there. First time in Good Neighbor? You can't go walking around without insurance. Hey, hold up there. First time in Good Neighbor? You can't go walking around without insurance.
Unless it's keep dumb assholes away from the insurance, I'm not interested.
Now don't be like that. I think you're gonna like what I have on offer. You hand over everything you got in their pockets, or accidents start happening to you. Big, bloody accidents.
Someone steps through the gate the first time, they're a guest. You lay off that exchange.
This is it for you. Wiping the floor with you.
I like you. Walk into a new place, make a show. It's nice. Good neighbors of the people, for the people. You feel me? Everyone's welcome.
I feel you.
Good. You stay cool, and you won't be part of the neighborhood. So long as you remember.
Mm-hmm.
What is it? should rest here. The place is built like a fortress. What the hell is a building that noise doing in a rundown city like this?
Up yours.
I told you to go away.
Let me in. Edward Deegan asked me to come here.
Oh, it's you. Good. Come on in.
All this time, I forgot my mic was on mute. Cool. Cut.
Come on. Let's go meet the boss.
Who's the boss?
Let's get on with it.
Hello, housekeeping.
Jack, the new gal is here.
One moment. I just have to.
He'll be right with us.
Oh, damn. Clearly, I'll need to adjust the mixture. Hello, hello. Welcome to Cabin House. I'm Jack Cabot.
Just tell me what you need me
just
to do.
Just tell me what you need me to do.
All in good time. Consider this your final interview before getting the job. Please, have a seat. How about a drink? Edward, the good bourbon, eh? Please, have a seat.
There might be some valuable stuff inside. Let's go
check
it out.
Wait a minute.
Now, before we get down to business, I have a question I like to ask all my new employees.
I've seen this video before.
The question is this. Do you believe there is other intelligent life in the universe?
I'm not sure there's any intelligent life in the universe. At least not on this planet.
You joke, but make a good point. Say humans perish from the Earth, as they seem intent upon doing. Say thousands of years from now, a new civilization arose. What would they know of us?
Start fresh, I always say.
Probably for the best if it was all wiped away. So whoever comes next can start fresh.
I don't share your pessimistic view. I still believe that human civilization has a chance to regain its lost glories. This is one reason I'm so passionate about my work. If I can learn the secrets of the ancients, perhaps we can avoid their fate.
Jack, can I tell her what I need her to do?
I'm sorry, Edward. I just get carried away sometimes. You're sending her to look for the missing shipment.
Yeah.
Well then, I'd better leave you to it. We'll talk more about this some other time, when things are less rushed. It isn't important now. Welcome to the family.
Okay. You're officially hired. Congratulations.
That was one hell of a whack job.
What a whack job.
Jack pays the bills, so he can believe what he wants. That's part of the job, by the way. It's best to keep an open mind. Jack may be eccentric, but he's definitely not crazy. The job I got for you is simple. Jack owns a facility north of the city. There's an important package that went missing between there and here. I need you to track it down and bring it back to me. Any questions?
Only like a million.
Only about a million.
You should start at Parsons State Insane Asylum. Don't let the name spook you. It's just a secure building that we're using. We think the courier got ambushed as he was leaving the place. The guards heard gunfire in the distance, but we don't know exactly what happened. Check in with Maria at Parsons. She's in charge of the security force there. She can point you in the right direction. You all set then?
Yep. I'll see you soon with the package.
Good luck. Don't get killed on your first job.
Wait, I forgot to ask what the package was.
Don't leave anything behind that might...
What? I said caravan or raider. Which are you?
I don't get it.
I really don't understand what you're asking. Seriously? This is Bunker Hill. All the caravans in the Commonwealth come through here, and every raider outfit in the area gets protection money to keep their paws off the market and our homes. So there's only two types of people coming through here, caravans and raiders. Which are you?
I'm here on my own.
Freelance, huh? All right. Come on in, but no gunfire. Market's open. You can do as much trading as you like.
Okay.
Hi, I'm Meg.
Hi, Meg. Hi, Meg. Don't you have any money?
Load a little heavy there? I'll buy anything you don't need.
What?
Thank you.
hold up.
Suck at aiming.
There's a story here, we'll find it. Can't wait to get out of this goddamn heat.
Hate to be messed with. it right.
Whoa. You hear that?
That looks really strong.
Must be getting jumpy.
Bada bing, bada boom.